वेलकम फ्रेंड्स, माझे मैत्री सुहास, असिस्टंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ ESDS डिपार्टमेंट फ्रॉम सद्गुरु कॉलेज ऑफ ॲग्रिकल्चर मिरजगाव. टुडे वी विल टेक द लेक्चर नंबर 3 फ्रॉम 5th सेमिस्टर ESDS कोर्स, दॅट इज फिजिको केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मिल्क. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल द इंट्रोडक्शन अबाउट फिजिको केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मिल्क. द नॉलेज ऑफ physicochemical properties of milk is essential for identification and effective quality control of milk. The quality of the final product will be best if raw milk is used with its optimum physicochemical properties. The important physicochemical properties of milk are physical appearance, taste, odor, density, specific gravity, acidity, pH, freezing point, boiling point, specific heat, thermal conductivity, heat stability, electrical conductivity, foaming, curd tension, viscosity, etc. Then these properties are briefly elaborated and described as below. The first property of milk is color of the milk. The white color of milk is due to the reflection of light by the dispersed fat globules and calcium cationate. The color of buffalo milk is creamy white due to the presence of casein. The yellow color of the cow milk is due to the presence of carotene pigment. The intensity of yellow color of cow milk depends on various factors such as breed, feed, size of fat globules, fat percentage, etc. The greater intake of green fodder or feed results in deeper yellow color of cow milk. The larger fat globules and higher fat percentage also results in increased intensity of yellow color. The skim milk has bluish and whey, greenish yellow color due to the presence of riboflavin pigments. The next property is taste and flavor. The flavor is a composite of smell, that is odor, and taste. The flavor of milk is a blend of sweet taste of lactose and salty taste of minerals. The phospholipids, fatty acids, and fat of milk also contribute to the flavor of the milk. The changes in the milk flavor may occur due to the type of feed, season, stage of lactation, condition of udder, sanitation during milking, and subsequent handling during processing. The pronounced flavor of any kind is considered abnormal. The source of the pronounced flavor may be the bacterial growth, feed, absorbed flavor, chemical composition of milk, the processing handling, then chemical changes, and last one is addition of foreign materials. These are the pronounced flavor of milk or of flavor of milk. Then next is the density and specific gravity of the milk. First of all, the definition of density. The density is defined as the mass per unit volume. And then next is the specific gravity. The specific gravity is defined as the ratio of density of substance to density of standard substance. The average specific gravity of bovine milk is 1.029 to 1.030. And it is slightly more than water, since all the soluble constituents of milk except fat have more specific gravity than water. The specific gravity of cow milk is 1.028 to 1.030. The specific gravity of buffalo milk is 1.030 to 1.032. Then the specific gravity of skim milk is 1.034 to 1.036. The specific gravity of milk is lower by addition of water and cream, and whereas the addition of skim milk and removal of fat increases the specific gravity of milk. Then next is the pH and acidity of milk. The pH is defined as the negative logarithm of hydrogen ion concentration. The normal fresh cow milk has a pH approximately 6.6 and buffalo milk has 6.7, which indicates that the milk is slightly acidic in nature. Then next is the acidity of milk. The acidity of milk may be defined as the ml of 0.1 normal NaOH solution or alkali required to neutralize lactic acid present in the milk. The acidity of cow milk is normally 0.13 to 0.14% and buffalo milk have 0.15 to 0.16%, and it is determined by titrating a known volume of milk with standard alkali using phenolphthalein indicator. The acidity of milk has two types, that is apparent or natural acidity and developed acidity. Both this acidity combines called as total acidity or titratable acidity. Then next is the freezing point of milk. First of all, the definition of freezing point. The temperature at which the vapor pressure of ice and water is equal called as freezing point, and it is expressed in degree Celsius or degree Fahrenheit. The freezing point of water is 32 degree Fahrenheit or 0 degree Celsius, while milk freezes at slightly lower temperature. The average freezing point is minus 0.549 degree Celsius for buffalo milk and minus 0.547 degree Celsius for cow milk, and it is measured by the instrument, that is cryoscope. The addition of water increases milk freezing point, and increase in acidity and addition of preservative in milk results in lowering the freezing point of the milk. The next property is boiling point. The boiling point is defined as the temperature at which the vapor pressure of liquid is equal to the vapor pressure of atmosphere. The milk is slightly heavier than water due to the soluble constituent of milk, and hence it has slightly higher boiling point than water, and it is also expressed in degree Celsius or degree Fahrenheit. The water boils at 212 degree Fahrenheit, that is 100 degree Celsius, and cow milk boils at 212.3 degree Fahrenheit, that is 100.17 degree Celsius, and buffalo milk boils at 100.55 degree Celsius. The milk boils more quickly than water because it requires least heat or less heat to raise its temperature than water. Then next is the specific heat of milk. First of all, the definition of specific heat. The specific heat of substance is a ratio between amount of heat required to raise its temperature by 1 degree and amount of heat required to raise the temperature of an equal mass of water by 1 degree. The unit of heat is calorie. Then next is the specific heat of whole milk at various temperatures. In that table, we can see the various levels of temperature and that temperature specific heat. At 0 degree Celsius, the specific heat of milk is 0.920, and at the temperature of 15 degrees Celsius, the specific heat is 0.938. Then at the temperature of 40 degrees Celsius, the specific heat of milk is 0.930, and at the temperature of 60 degrees Celsius, the specific heat is 0.918. Then for the determination of specific heat, the calorimeter is used. The specific heat of milk is lower than the water. The specific heat of water is 1. Thus, milk requires less heat to raise the temperature compared to same quantity of water. Then next is the surface tension. The surface tension may be defined as a state of stress at surface of liquid due to the cohesive attraction of molecules for each other. The surface tension of water at 20 degrees Celsius is 72.15 dynes. The surface tension of cow milk is 42.50 dynes per centimeter, and for buffalo milk is 45.50 dynes per centimeter at 20 degrees Celsius. Commonly, surface tension is measured at 20 degrees Celsius. Increase in fat and protein content of milk lowers the surface tension, and aging of raw milk lowers the surface tension, but aging of pasteurized milk raises the surface tension of milk. The increase in the temperature of milk lowers the surface tension of milk. Next is the viscosity. The viscosity is the resistance offered by a liquid to flow, agitation or shear is called viscosity. This resistance is due to the internal friction within the liquid as they slide each other. The viscosity of water at 20 degrees Celsius is 1.005 centifolds. Hence, it flows easily. The milk is slightly more viscous than water due to the presence of solids in the milk. The whole milk has a viscosity about 1.631 centipoles, and skim milk has 1.404 centipoles. The viscosity can be measured either by viscometer. The commercially, viscosity is more important in manufacture and marketing of cream and ice cream. The next property is foaming. The foaming is nothing but it is common ability of milk and some products to form a foam. In case of whipping cream, it is desirable, but during the bottle filling and separation of milk, it is undesirable. The proteins are a brief cause of foam. The protein content of skim milk foam is from 0.12 to 0.16% than skim milk. The low temperature, that is 2 to 4 degrees Celsius, is favorable for the formation of foam, while the temperature is around 16 to 32 degrees Celsius gives the lowest foam formation. The homogenization increases the foam when it is measured at temperature 4 to 27 degrees Celsius and decreases the amount of foam at 60 degrees Celsius. Then next is the refractive index. The refractive index is the velocity of light varies with the density of medium through which it passes. The refractive index of milk at 20 degrees Celsius has a range of 1.3440 to 1.3480. The refractive index of water is 1.3329, which is lower than milk, and as milk is a dissolved material, and it is measured by using immersion refractometer or Abbe's refractometer. Okay, thank you.